Scary today, in that Transfiguration Sunday, where a glimpse of God's glory and His majesty is shown to a few of His disciples. In the presence of God, through word and sacrament, through our personal time in prayer and that personal devotion, that we are changed, we're transformed into His likeness. And so we come into His presence today, believing and trusting in the promise. So we make our beginning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Of God, as we stand before our God, our Maker, and before one another, we make confession of our sins. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us then confess our sins to God, our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your penalty and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us. Renew us and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways for the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all of your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and only by his authority, I therefore forgive you all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Son, you gave us a glimpse of his glory and majesty. We pray that you would transform us and empower us to serve you in word and deed, so that the light of Jesus Christ might shine through our lives to bring honor and majesty to you. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Our Old Testament lesson for this day, recorded in the words of Moses himself from Exodus chapter 34. When Moses came down from Mount Sinai, with the two tablets of the testimony in his hand, and he came down from the mountain. Moses did not know that the skin of his face shone because he had been talking with God. Aaron and all the people of Israel saw Moses, and behold, the skin of his face shone, and they were afraid to come near him. But Moses called to them, and Aaron and all the leaders of the congregation returned to him, and Moses talked with them. Afterward, all the people of Israel came near, and he commanded them all the Lord had spoken with him in Mount Sinai. And when Moses had finished speaking with them, he put a veil over his face. Whenever Moses went in before the Lord to speak with him, he would remove the veil until he came out. And when he came out and told the people of Israel what he was commanded, the people of Israel would see the face of Moses, that the skin of Moses' face was shining, and Moses would put the veil over his face again until he went in to speak with them. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. From Paul's second letter to the Christians in Corinth, the third chapter. Since we have such a hope, we are very bold, not like Moses, who put a veil over his face so that the Israelites might not gaze at the outcome of what was being brought to an end. But their minds were hardened, for to this day, when they read the Old Covenant, the same veil remains unlifted, because only through Christ is it taken away. Yes, to this day, whenever Moses is read, a veil lies over their hearts. But when one turns to the Lord, the veil is removed. So the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And we all, with unveiled face, beholding the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit. In their case, the God of this world has blinded the minds of unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For what we proclaim is not ourselves, but Jesus Christ is Lord, with ourselves as your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," has shone in our hearts to give light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. This too, the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We stand now in respect for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 9th chapter. And after 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became radiant, intensely white, as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, and they were talking with Jesus. And Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make 3 tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." For he did not know what to say, for they were terrified. And a cloud overshadowed them, and a voice came out of the cloud, "This is my beloved Son, listen to him." And suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone with them but Jesus only. And as they were coming down the mountain, he charged them to tell no one what they had seen until the Son of Man had risen from the dead. This is the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. Well, it's Valentine's Day, and it's a day where we celebrate love. Typically, we would send cards or give candy out, and that's a way of showing affection. What love really looks like to us is, as Christians, is more than just a card or a letter or a bracelet, something that is given out, because a card probably finds the trash one day. Candy finds its way too easily into our stomachs, and we see the box as empty. Or sometimes, as that candy is given away, it just sits in the box. Some are afraid to open it. Some just don't like how it tastes. Sometimes we just forget about it, and it gets old, and then that too finds the trash. What we have today is the love of Christ that speaks into each of our lives, the love of God that knows no bounds, that it is always applicable, it is always there for us, although it's not always received. And sometimes people would just push off that love as we are bold in our witness to be able to share the gospel of Jesus Christ, the light of Christ, and it's dimmed. And people would say, thanks, I've heard that before, and it's just not for me. It's like a card that finds the trash or candy that sits on the shelf and gets old. But the love of Jesus accomplishes that for which he sends it. As God's word is spoken, that we proclaim it. Sometimes we forget it. But let that not be the case for us today, that you know that you are loved and that he sends his son, Jesus Christ, into the world so that all who believe in him may not perish but have eternal life. That's love. That's what it looks like. As you go today, there are a few cards. There are some bracelets out there. You can put the bracelet on, you kids, and wear that. For some adults, it's probably not very, it's not big enough for us, probably, most of our wrists. But there's a card for you, Valentine's Day card, but then also a card that you can tear off and give to someone else. It really is about a bold witness to be able to share the love of Jesus with those around us, that we all need to hear it. We all need to be reminded of it, that Jesus loves you and forgives you all your sins. God's grace and his peace is yours in Jesus Christ. It is good for us to be here, to be in the presence of others, believers, those who believe and don't doubt, those who are bold in their witness as we share the gospel of Jesus Christ. It is a light that shines through the darkness, a light that is like no other light. And it does change us as we spend time in his word. It's difficult for us, I think, sometimes that we don't and aren't able to really share because of the mask that we have on, that we're hidden behind almost a curtain, if you will, that you can smile from here to here, and you can tell, and it does change us, and so that as good as it is for us to be here, that we're filled with the light of Christ, that we take this message and we take the joy that we have in Jesus into the world so that they might too see the glory of God in Jesus Christ. So I'm dating myself to be sure. You know what those curtains are? Remember that game show, Let's Make a Deal? So curtain 1, 2, and 3, people donning costumes of all shapes and sizes, acting a fool, if you will. And ma'am, remember Monty Hall would say, ma'am, if you have a paperclip in your bag, I'll give you $50 for every paperclip that's in your bag. For every clothespin, people nowadays don't even know what a clothespin is, but even so, $120 for every one of those, sir, that you have in your pocket. that they would try to gain access to winning a prize. And then as they win the prize, then at the end, those top three prize getters, they would be given the option, do you want to swap what you already have for something else, a chance of what is behind the veiled curtain, or do you want to keep what you have? Some would say, nope, I'm not going to risk it. But because behind one of those curtains is, you know what they call them? The donkey, right? The horse, the little baby in a carriage with a bottle. It was a zonk. And that you could lose it all and come away with nothing. Jesus is not operating that way on this Transfiguration Sunday. He's not trying to trick us or not trying to coax us out of something, but that he has come so that we might have life and live it to the full. On the top of Mount Sinai, we have Moses standing, and his light, his face lights up like no other light. As he speaks these words, when Moses came down from Mount Sinai with the two tablets of the testimony in his hand, he came down the mountain. Moses did not know that the skin of his face shone because he had been talking with God. This is not the first trip down the mountain, you remember, from Moses, that he had the Ten Commandments in his hands as he was gone for 40 days up on the top of this mountain. And there was thunder, and there was lightning, and there was all the things that were happening up on there. So as you looked from afar, the people of the Israelites were down on the ground, and they said, man, he's gone. He's not coming back. Did you see all that was happening? And it turns out that Moses was spending time with God. And he comes down the mountain that first time, and there they are. Their faith had been veiled. It was hidden. And the golden calf. And so those tablets of stone were thrown on the ground and broken into pieces because they had broken his covenant. And Moses goes back up this time and spends time with God. And he didn't know it, but he had been changed. His face started to absorb the glory of God. And as he went back down the mountain again, it was so different. And that the people of God were afraid, and they were ashamed, and they ran away. So Moses said, I've got something to share with you. And so there is forgiveness in this God of ours, and that he does love you enough to give you these commandments. That's what love looks like. And as he gives these commandments to them, soon as the word of God was preached, he puts a veil over his face so that to keep and veil that glory and hide it, because it was frightening actually to see that you could be changed by being with God. That God does change us. He changes us today through word and sacrament. He changes us as the scriptures are opened, that we see it as believers. We're changed as believers. And there is this bold and certain hope in the gospel of Christ. Yet there are times when we're not so bold, when we too are frightened, when we try to hide. We think that we don't have the words to speak, and so we just don't speak at all. And so the gospel is veiled then, because if we don't speak, who will? And God gives to us a message of hope. Again, on the top of the mountain that we call the Mount of Transfiguration, Peter, James, and John are there with Jesus. That Jesus walks in the body of a man, that he looks just like you and I, yet he is God. He is the Son of God. And that is the gospel that we proclaim. And it was there on the Mount of Transfiguration that Moses, who was veiled no longer, and Elijah the prophet, they stand. And they speak with Jesus, and we get a glimpse of what Jesus and who he really is. To be able to see Peter, James, and John, they too, as he shines like the sun, and his robe and clothes are as white as anyone could bleach them, is what the scriptures tell us, that this was different, and they were afraid. And they didn't know what to say. How about, let's make three shelters, one for you, one for Moses, one for Elijah. And Jesus said, it's not that time. That's not why we're here. And the cloud envelops Jesus and Moses and Elijah, and then as the cloud is lifted, as that veil is taken away, they see Jesus only. And Jesus says, don't tell anyone what you've seen until the Son of Man has risen from the dead. Well, today as we stand on that Mount of Transfiguration, he bids us to go. But he doesn't bid us to keep that message to ourselves. Because he has risen from the dead through the glory of the Father, and we too live a new life because we are changed. We are able to witness and hear through Paul's words, for God who said, let light shine out of the darkness, has shown in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. That we do have something that we give to God. We don't trade it, but we give God the glory. We give him our sin, and that he takes it away, because too often we are afraid to speak. Too often we are acting a fool. Too often we take what the world has to offer, and it leaves us wanting. It leaves us with nothing. But the glory of God continues to shine brightly today through his word. Through this Valentine's Day, through the cross, we're able to see what glory really is. That we take our sins and the darkness that's in our lives, and we take them to the cross. And we say, forgive me, Lord, for I have sinned. I have fallen short of the glory of God. I am not living my life as I should. My face doesn't show it. My actions don't show it. My life has fallen apart. God, I need you. That's why Jesus came, to live on the cross, to die on the cross for each of our sins. One-time sacrifice for all. That as he looks at those who are around the cross, as he looks at us, you have no idea, but I do. And then he breathed his last, and it was there, as the centurion witnesses, truly this is the Son of God. And then as Jesus breathed his last, the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Because the holiest of holies, only the high priest could go back. And no one else. They had the access to God. But now, because of the sacrifice of Jesus, the veil has been removed. That it's torn from top to bottom. You have direct access to God the Father. To shine with the light that is in him as he gives to us. To share that love with those who we come into contact. Share that in our own homes and in our communities. To shine with that brightness and the glory and the majesty this side of heaven as best we can. That God is present among us, and that we are able to have a hope that does not disappoint. To be bold in your witness, to be bold in that proclamation of the gospel. For Jesus changes everything. transfiguration, transformation, changing from not only the heart, but into our hands as well. To be bold. And Scripture says not only to be bold, but to be very bold in that proclamation, that you might shine with His light today as we stand, as we proclaim Jesus, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Please stand. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. As the offerings are brought forward to us today, again, it is a symbol of what God gives to us first, that He has chosen us, provided for us. And as we do that, we're bold in the proclamation. So we pray that there is this bold proclamation through the gifts, through the tithes, through the offerings, through what God gives to us, so that we might not be timid, that we might not be veiled as a congregation or as an individual, that we proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is the Son of God. And it's our privilege to be able to share Him with others. We pray. Lord God, we thank You for the ability to stand in Your presence today, to be changed, to be transformed. Lord, give to us not a timid spirit, but one that is bold in proclamation. Lord, for the glory that is in Christ our Lord, that is to be revealed to the world, that we may be transformed by that same power, by the same Holy Spirit, to show His glory, that we proclaim Him and not ourselves. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy for the grace to celebrate the revelation of Christ's glory and for the courage to follow the journey to the cross. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy for the church of God, because it is Your church, O Lord, that it may be faithful, that we may be faithful, that we may be bold in that proclamation, and that we may have the courage to speak God's law and gospel in the world. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy for all who suffer from illness or troubled minds or spirits or loneliness or doubt. Lord, help them not to be timid, but to be bold, to be changed, to be transformed by Your healing hand. We pray today for Carol Affelt and Ken Dutcher. We remember Mike Horniman and Lois Wentz. We pray, Lord, for Bill Snow and for Carol Ott. Lord, be with June Vipond and Jeannie Stramer. We ask for Your blessings and a strength from above for Nancy Bouchard, for Ingrid Dixon, and for Drew Sinke. Lord, for so many others in our hearts, on our minds today. Lord God, that You would supply the needs of all who call on You, that they might be bold as they believe in the promise that You have come, You have died, and You will come again. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Now to Him who is able and ready to supply all human needs, whose light shines forth in His transfiguration, be all glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. Lord, remember us in Your kingdom. Would You teach us to pray? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated, if you will. Just an announcement before the benediction and the closing of the service. For those of you who are at home, not quite ready to return to worship with a number of your brothers and sisters here in Christ, we do want to remind you that there is a communion in a smaller fashion, if you will, just smaller numbers, and we'll have the opportunity for both word and the sacrament of Holy Communion. There is a sign-up online. You can sign up, and we'll see you on Tuesday at 6 o'clock. So the Lord be with you. I look forward to seeing you as you come. As we go from this place, changed and transformed by His Word, by His power, that we've seen His glory, that you would go with this hope that lives within you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you, be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with His favor, give to you His peace. Amen. Again, the Lord blesses us, and we are in His glory. Jesus walked in the desert and was tempted by Satan himself for those 40 days, that he does climb the Mount of Transfiguration. He gives a glimpse of that glory. As we walk through these days of Lent, in these 40 days, that we stand in the presence of God. He hasn't left us, He hasn't gone away, but He gives us that promise that He will die and that He will rise again. There are devotionals, Lent devotionals, as you go today on the Information Center, so please pick those up. Be bold in your proclamation, passing those devotions along to neighbors and friends, people that aren't able to join us for whatever reason. For those of you who are online worshiping with us today, those devotions are online, or if you'd like one, just call the church office, and we'll make sure we'll get one into your hands. Also, today, there are little butterflies for the kids to color. If you have those with, there will be a box, and you can place those box. Bring them up on the altar today if you have them, and just set them right here on the altar. We'll make sure they get them into to the proper place. We sing Alleluia for the last time until Easter. So the Lord bless us. We give those praises today. He does transform us. He changes us into His image, into His likeness of Jesus Christ.
Thank you. Good.